This amateur footage shows unidentified gunmen firing on an unarmed crowd after ejecting them from a polling station in Krasnoarmeysk. The tension in eastern Ukraine is turning to violence on an almost daily basis now. It is unlikely to ease after thousands turned out to vote in the region's referendum on whether to split from the rest of Ukraine.
I want peace in this country. I don't want this horrible mess from Kiev that they created in the Maidan, a war, the killing of people, and it continues here.
The government in Kiev is adamant it won't recognize the vote.
I would like to underline one more time, it's not a referendum. It is a desultory attempt by terrorists, bandits and killers to cover their activity by having citizens vote in Luhansk and Donetsk.
Kiev's word doesn't carry much weight among those keen to endorse the self-declared People's Republic of Donetsk.
There have been no official monitors or observers, but among the media observing, reports of piles of yes votes in see-through ballot boxes like these ones. Lots of allegations of repeat voting, very little sign of no votes. And that's because there are genuinely a lot of people keen to embrace the idea of some form of autonomy for this region. But it's also because those against are afraid to speak out.
I did find one man willing to explain why he was against the referendum movement, but he was scared and he didn't want to be identified.
They don't understand what kind of a threat it poses and what can happen as a result. It appears that Russia doesn't want us and we are parting from Ukraine. Left on its own, this region heads towards catastrophe.
There are ample signs of catastrophe unfolding. As votes were counted in the fortified separatist stronghold of Slavyansk, Ukrainian forces on its outskirts were said to be preparing for the final phase of an operation to clear the town. The government in Kiev says Sunday's referendum will tip the region into the abyss. Some here feel that's already happened. Jonah Hull, Al Jazeera, Donetsk.